Would you call him a friend?
Wow. I call him beloved. If a definition of a friend is someone you hang out with, you know, at the bar or, you know, at the church, no. He was a client and beloved. If you can expand the definition of friendship as, you know, mutual respect, a mutual connection, endearing qualities, enjoying each other's company, then he was a friend.
You know, it's interesting. You knew him 35 years. Was he the type of guy who said, 30 years, let's go out and eat? Let's come over to the house?
No.
So there was a little distance maybe between him and... Was he like that with other people? Did you ever see him gregarious?
Well, that's an excellent question. He was friendly and warm. No.
He just...
He was very... contained, all right? I guess I'm kind of like that myself, you know. I mean, I can be friendly, but I can also, I don't mind being alone either. No, he wasn't gregarious.
It's interesting because along with the movie and the stamp and this being the 50th year and his 90th birthday was Tuesday, okay. This summer there's a documentary coming out. And from what I've read, very good documentary, but digs a little more into the man, Fred Rogers. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to misspeak because I haven't seen the documentary, but I guess he had written that he and his children had some moments in life. I think they talk about that in the documentary. I read that somewhere.
I read it too.
Yeah,
I was at their house, and the two boys were, they kind of kept to themselves. The first time I met them, I had been to Fred's house for a day. We spent a day there photographing and meeting his wife and photographing Fred and her at the piano. And I met John and James. But it was kind of out of the corner of my eye. I met them.
You were at the house. Joanne will be there tomorrow. I believe she's getting along well these days. I believe 91 years old. Good for her, and she's going to be there tomorrow. You witnessed them. You took pictures of them. What was that relationship like?
It was 50s, 60s couples. You know, the man and woman. It's kind of like my grandparents. You know, they loved each other. And they had the respect for each other's role, right? It wasn't she's trying to be him and he's trying to be her. Fred was Fred and Joanne was Joanne, and they actually sat at the piano and they sang together, did a duet together. And my family was like that too. My mother was a pianist and my dad played the violin, and we used to sit around the piano and sing. And she actually had us go out, and we're doing four-part harmony when we're 6 years old.
Yeah,
so we used to entertain at my dad. He worked for U.S. Steel, and we used to do the Christmas show every year. So we would sing at the show, and we hated wearing our little suits and ties, and we're like, especially during the rehearsals. I want to be outside. I don't want to be here singing these things.
I understand.
But Fred and John, I think very reserved. You know, I can't make a judgment. I just saw them, they were, I mean, when I'm there with a camera, he's public, right?
What do you know about Fred Rogers that we don't?
What a great guy he was. That what he is, that he's the same person in real life as he is. Well, no, what am I saying? It's all real life. Fred is consistent. Yeah, he's a consistent person. He doesn't change when he's off camera.
Being with him for 33 years, the show ended in August of 2001.
Yes.
And he passed away less than 2 years later.
Yeah, from stomach cancer.
When did you hear of that? That he was ill?
Well, actually, I attended the services.
Oh, you went to
I went to the services at Heinz Hall. And, his son spoke, and the place was packed. It was just jam-packed.
Did you know he was ill?
I didn't know he was ill, no.
So when somebody called you and said he had left us, what hit you?
How, that who poisoned this man? He was a vegetarian.
Yeah.
And he died of stomach cancer. I have thoughts about Monsanto. Excuse me.
you never know. You never know.
Yeah. But he swam. He was healthy. And I know I was overweight. And all my friends kept giving me, you got to lose weight. I said, the guy that ate the pine cones, he was 49. He passed away, And I know Fred was healthy, And 74 is and that's my age now. And I said, well, my heroes are Chubby Checker, Fats Domino. I said, they're 85, they're 90 years old. And, they smoke, they drink, and they have fun. I said, so your diet advice and your exercise advice, I said, it's falling on deaf ears here. So I said, I feel good.